You swiping that card a lot this time of year? You're afraid it's going to catch fire? You're swiping it so much? Settle down. Our next guest, finance expert, Dr. Cozette M. White. She has advice for those of us who get a little carried away during the holidays. Cozette's also a tax resolution expert, and she joins us now. It's great having you.
Good morning. How are you?
Doing very well. As you know, the birds are chirping. The economy's improved. You're seeing consumer confidence is at the highest level in nearly two decades.
Exactly.
People are spending like money's not a thing.
Right.
But it is a thing.
It is a thing. People are spending. They're spending more this holiday season.
And they've already started, haven't they?
They've already started. Most have started, and most will wrap up before the Thanksgiving holiday.
Wow.
Of course, we'll have some that will be triggering in the month of December, but studies show that most have already started, and before that Thanksgiving holiday, people will have already cha-ching swiped those cards.
Who does most of the shopping during the holidays? I know it's not the guys. It can't be the guys.
No, it's not the guys, yeah. But studies show 5 out of 6 people are shopping, and when we say who, most of it is the millennials.
Aha.
We show that the millennials are doing most of the shopping. And on average, the average price is about $819 when we talk about spending. So the millennials are spending somewhere about $861. So it is our millennials that are spending.
Well, at least they have money to spend. That's
right,
good.
Right.
Supposedly.
Maybe.
So what are the top gifts that are being scooped up this time of season? What are they spending that money on?
So some of the top gifts that we'll see this year are, number one, the gift cards. Then we have apparel. Apparel is right at about 63%. And of course, we have to get the toys. The toys will be bought for the young ones, the kids, and the adults. Our adults like toys
as
well.
Of course, yeah, no doubt.
And then, of course, the technology. Technology is one of the hot gifts that we will see this season.
And it's the toughest thing to shop for.
Yes.
And it's the first thing you're going to end up replacing.
First thing to replace, because it changes so often.
What are your thoughts on actually spending money on gift cards? Wise?
For one, I'd say yes. I know we have this conversation, but
yeah.
Gift cards are great because it allows the person to get whatever they want.
Yeah.
Now, there's this also notion that some people have gift cards still sitting around.
Yeah.
I have 2 gift cards that I carry with me, and I got them last Christmas.
Wow.
So, yes.
You're just waiting for that moment to spend them. At least you
carry
them with you.
I
have
stuff
in like an envelope back in the house. It's probably from 4 years ago.
Yes.
I got wedding gifts I haven't spent yet.
Oh,
from
wow.
4 years ago.
Wow.
Unbelievable.
Okay.
The one thing that I think is the pitfall for a lot of people that are spending all the money during the holiday season is impulse buys.
Yes.
They got all that stuff at the register or that last thing, or they're trying to grab you on that thing you don't really need. It's probably chintzy.
Yes.
But you buy it.
Yes.
How do we stop ourselves from doing that?
Okay. Impulse buying. Let's talk about that. And that's usually what gets us in trouble.
Yeah.
Studies show that buyers, when they're out shopping, they usually have a tendency to spend on themselves. So here are some of the things that I would recommend to buyers to help you from that impulse buying.
Okay.
Number one, you can freeze your credit cards. Okay.
Really?
Now, you may say, well, do you put that in the freezer? What is it that you actually mean?
Put it in a block of ice, yes.
by freezing your credit card. You can definitely freeze your credit card by simply calling the creditors, asking them to lower the spending limit on those credit cards.
Wow.
During the holiday season. So I usually say October through December, let's decrease what that looks like. Let's decrease that so that you're not out just sporadically spending on yourself. And it'll help you in the long run.
Of course, yeah.
Mm-hmm.
The other one you say is don't buy gifts for everyone.
Right. Now, we have a tendency to think that, oh, we have to get a gift for everyone in the office, all of our friends. That will put you in trouble. Make a list. And make a list that's really frugal,
mm-hmm.
a frugal list,
yeah.
Those that you really need. Don't try to get the gifts for everyone. Don't try to go to the Christmas dinner and go, oh, I forgot to get these gifts for these individuals. They were not part of the budget. They
yep.
were not part of the plan.
Yep.
So let's do without them.
And honestly, when you give the gift to them, now you've put them on the spot where they have to get a gift for you, and now everyone's in debt.
Exactly.
Exactly. The other thing you say, this is a smart idea, is use a prepaid card. If you don't necessarily lower the limit, but you say, here's what I'm allowing myself to spend, you put the money on that card, now you have your limit on that card.
Exactly. A prepaid card will allow you to say, okay, my budget is $2,000 for this holiday season. Once you get to that $2,000, you know that you have reached your limit. And be disciplined. Be that person that says, okay, I'm not going to go and take any additional money out, and that's your limit.
Mm-hmm.
You have to stop there. You can't go and get those extra gifts for those that you may have not gotten gifts for.
15 seconds, one more tip, junk mail.
Oh my goodness, junk mail, that can definitely get you. I have a policy, and I tell this to everyone, when the junk mail arrives in the mail, you should discard of it, put it in a bin before it even comes
yeah.
in the house. Okay, if not, you'll have a tendency to spend, so just throw it away immediately.
Absolutely. I'll let you know, by the way, we have a book. You have a book? Let's talk about this book.
My book, Unveiling the Mask. Oh, my goodness. It's a book about rebouncing, how to rebounce after financial disaster. The book is available. It's available on Amazon.com. It is a best-selling book, and you can get it by either going over to Amazon or to unveilingthemask.com.
And speaking of books, you also have a free ebook download as well. Let's talk about that.
Yes, I love to give free things to those of you who are looking to rebound, get your finances in order. Mm-hmm. For your free downloadable book, anyone who's out there, all they need to do is go to iconquermoneyblocks.com.
Okay.
iconquermoneyblocks.com for a free e-loadable book, and it'll just give you the basics on what you need to do to conquer your money.
All right.
Affirmations and things of that nature.
We're doing a prepaid card this year, I'm telling
you.
Oh, we got to rein it in. It's great having you, Cozette. Thank
Absolutely.
You so much.
Absolutely. Thanks.
All right. Get your financial home in order with My Financial Home. Visit MyFinancialHome.com or call the number on your screen. My Financial Home Enterprises, a proud sponsor of the Morning Blend. And by the way, if you're in LA on Friday, she's going to be there for a workshop.